Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Son of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
have mercy. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of
church of God, for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our Metropolitan Tegan, for our Archbishop Benjamin, for the honorable priests, for the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city and country, for the faithful dwelling in them, let us pray to the Lord. For seasonal weather, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by land, by sea, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. Large, deliverance, small affliction, wrath, danger, necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God. For unto thee art all glory, honor, worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Unto the Lord is my affection, have I cried.
And he heard me.
O Lord, deliver my soul from my God.
And from a crafty tongue.
What shall be given unto thee?
And what shall be added unto thee for thy crafty tongue?
The arrows of the law and the teeth of the
sharp as the bulls of the desert.
Oh, it's made for my sojourning, it's prolonged.
I have tented with the tentings of Kedar.
My soul hath long been a sojourner.
With them that hate it, peace I was peaceable.
When I spake unto them,
they warred against me without a cause.
I have lifted up mine eyes to the mountain.
From whence cometh my help?
Give that very foot of the moon.
Who hath made heaven and the earth?
Give that very foot of the moon.
And may he not slumber that keepeth thee?
Behold, he shall not slumber nor shall he sleep.
He that keepeth Israel,
the Lord shall keep thee.
The Lord is the shelter at thy right hand.
The sun shall not burn thee by day,
nor the moon by night.
The Lord shall keep thee from all evil.
The Lord shall guard thy soul.
The Lord shall keep thy coming in and thy going out.
From henceforth and forevermore.
I was glad because of them that said unto me,
let us go into the house of the Lord.
Our feet have stood in thy courts, O Jerusalem.
Jerusalem is builded as a city,
which its dwellers shall share in concord.
For there the tribes went up.
The tribes of the Lord is a testimony for Israel.
To give thanks to the name of the Lord.
For there are set the thrones unto judgment.
Thrones over the house of David.
Ask now for the things which are for the peace of Jerusalem,
and for the prosperity of them that love thee.
Let peace be now in thy strength,
and prosperity in thy palaces.
For the sake of my brethren and my neighbors,
speak peace concerning thee.
Because of the house of the Lord our God,
I have such good things for thee.
Unto thee have I lifted up my heart,
unto thee that dwellest in heaven.
Behold, as the eyes of servants look unto the hands of their master,
as the eyes of the handmaid look unto the hands of her mistress,
so do our eyes look unto the Lord our God.
Until he take pity on us.
Have mercy on us, O Lord, have mercy on us.
For greatly are we filled with abasement.
Greatly hath our soul been filled therewith.
Let reproach come upon them that prosper in abasement on the proud.
Had it not been that the Lord was with us,
let Israel now say, had it not been that the Lord was with us,
when they rose up against us,
then hath they swallowed us up alive.
When their wrath raged against us,
then hath the water overwhelmed us.
Our soul hath passed through a torrent.
Then hath our soul passed through the water that is irresistible.
Blessed be the Lord who hath not given us
to be a prey to their teeth.
Our soul like a sparrow was delivered
out of the snare of the hunter.
The snare is broken,
and we are delivered.
Our help is in the name of the Lord,
who hath made heaven and the earth.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Amen. Hallelujah.
again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorate to your most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God. Thine is the majesty, thine is the kingdom, and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages. Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorate your most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and one another, and all our life unto Christ our God. Thou art a good God, lovest mankind, and thee we send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
hast thou requited my soul.
That is why I hope in the Lord.
From henceforth and forevermore.
Remember, O Lord, David, and all his meetings.
How he made an oath unto the Lord.
And vowed unto the God of Jacob.
I shall not go into the dwelling of my house.
I shall not ascend upon the bed of my couch.
I shall not give sleep to mine eyelids.
Nor slumber to my eyes.
Nor rest to my temple.
Until I find a place for the Lord.
A habitation for the God of Jacob.
Though we have heard of it from above.
We have founded it in the plains of the wood.
Let us go forth into his tabernacle.
Let us worship at the place where his feet have stood.
Rise, O Lord, unto
thou in the ark of thy holiness.
I preach of his love and righteousness.
And thy righteous shall rejoice.
For the sake of David, thy son.
Turn not thy face away from thine anointed one. And he will not annul it. If thy sons keep my covenant, their sons shall also sit on thy throne forever.
For the Lord hath elected Zion.
And he hath chosen her to be a habitation for himself.
This is my rest forever and ever.
Here will I dwell, for I have chosen her. Her beggars will I satisfy with bread.
Her priests will I clothe with salvation.
And her saints with rejoicing shall rejoice.
Where will I make to spring for the Lord of David?
I have prepared a lamb for my Christ.
His enemies will I clothe with shame.
But upon him shall my sanctification flourish.
Even now, what is so good or so glorious?
As for brethren to dwell together in unity,
it is like the oil of the head,
which runneth down upon the beard,
upon the beard of Aaron,
which runneth down unto the fringe of his raiment,
it is like the dew of Aaron,
which cometh down upon the mountains of Zion,
where there the Lord commanded from mercy,
life forevermore. All ye servants of the Lord,
stand at the house.
In the courts of the house of our God. And to the holies and bless the Lord.
The Lord will bless the elements of
He that made heaven and the earth.
Again, again, in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Commemorating our most holy, most pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady Theotokos, never Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another, and all our life unto Christ our God. Thou art our God, a merciful and saving God, unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Thank you.
supplication. Oh, pour out before my supplication, my affliction before him, while I declare, when my spirit was fainting within me, then thou knewest my paths. In this way, when I have walked, they have hid from me a snare. I looked upon my right hand and beheld, and there was none that did know me. Flight hath failed me, and there is none that watches out for my soul. I have cried unto thee, O Lord, I said, thou art my hope. My portion art thou in the land of the living. Attend unto my supplication, for I brought very low. Deliver me from them that persecute me, for they are stronger than I. Bring my soul out of prison.
Depths that I cried unto thee, O Lord.
O Lord,
Amen.
hesitant. Peace be unto all wisdom.
Prokimenon is in the fourth tone. I will walk before the Lord in the land of the living. I love the Lord because he has heard my voice and my supplication.
I will walk acceptably before the Lord in the land of the living.
I will walk acceptably before the Lord
in the land of the living.
Wisdom.
Reading is from Genesis.
Verse 10.
Joseph came home, they brought into the house to him the present which they had with them, and bowed down to him on the ground. And he inquired about their welfare and said, is your father well? The old man of whom you spoke, is he still alive? They said, your servant, our father, is well. He is still alive. And they bowed their heads and made obeisance. And he lifted up his eyes and saw his brother Benjamin, his mother's son, and said, is this your youngest brother whom you spoke to me? God be gracious unto you, my son. And Joseph made haste, for his heart yearned for his brother, and he sought a place to weep. And he entered into his chamber and wept there. And he washed his face and came out, and controlling himself, he said, let food be served. Then Joseph could not control himself before all those who stood by him. And he cried, make everyone go out from me. So no one stayed with him when Joseph made himself known to his brothers. And he wept aloud so that the Egyptians heard it, and the household of Pharaoh heard it. And Joseph said to his brothers, I am Joseph. Is my father still alive? But his brothers could not answer him, for they were dismayed at his presence. So Joseph said to his brothers, come near, I pray you. And they came near, and he said, I am your brother Joseph, whom you sold into Egypt. And now do not be distressed or angry with yourselves, because you sold me here, for God sent me before you to preserve life. For the famine has been in the land these 2 years, and there are yet 5 years in which there will be neither plowing nor harvest. And God sent me before you to preserve for you a remnant on earth, and to keep alive for you many survivors. So it is not you who sent me here, but God. And he has made me a father to Pharaoh, and lord of all of his house, and ruler over all the land of Egypt. So make haste and go up to my father and say to him, thus says your son Joseph, God has made me lord of all of Egypt. Come down to me, do not tarry. You shall dwell in the land of Goshen, and you shall be near me, you and your children and your children's children and your flocks, your herds, and all that you have. And there I will provide for you, for there are yet 5 years of famine left to come, lest you and your household and all that you have come to poverty. And now your eyes see, and the eyes of my brother Benjamin see, that it is my mouth that speaks to you. You must tell my father of all my splendor in Egypt, and all of that you and all that you have seen. Make haste and bring my father down here. Then he fell upon his brother Benjamin's neck and wept, and Benjamin wept upon his neck, and he kissed all his brothers and wept upon them. And after that his brothers talked to him. When the report was heard in Pharaoh's house, Joseph's brothers have come. It pleased Pharaoh and his servants well.
Let us attend.
The Prokimenon is in the fourth tone. I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all of his people.
I will pay my vows to the Lord in the presence of all his people.
I will pay my vows to the Lord
in the presence of all his people.
Wisdom, let us attend. The light of Christ illumineth all. Let us attend.
wicked covets what the righteous gives and does not hold back. The sacrifice of the wicked is abomination. How much more when he brings faithlessness to the land? False witness will perish with the word of a man who hears it from the Lord. A wicked man puts on a bold face, but an upright man considers his ways. No wisdom or understanding or counsel can avail against the Lord. The house is made ready for the day of battle, but the victory belongs to the Lord. The good name is to be the chosen, rather than great riches and favor, better than silver or gold. The rich and the poor meet together. The Lord is the maker of them all. A prudent man sees danger and hides himself, but the simple go on to suffer for it. The reward for their humility and fear of the Lord is riches and honor and life.
Peace be unto thee, reader, wisdom.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
The lifting up of my hands, the Lord, Mass of my life, give me not the spirit of sloth, despair, lust of power, and idle talk. But give rather the spirit of chastity, humility, patience, and love to thy servant. Yea, Lord and King, grant me to see my own transgressions and not to judge my brother. For blessed art thou to ages of ages. Amen. Let us say with all our souls and all our mind, let us say.
Lord, have mercy.
O Lord, Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Have mercy on us, O God, according to thy great goodness, we pray thee, hearken and have mercy. Again we pray for our Metropolitan Deacon, for Archbishop Benjamin, for priests, monks, deacons, and all the clergy, and for all our brethren in Christ. Again we pray for this country, its president, for all civil authorities, and for the armed forces everywhere. Again we pray for the blessed ever memorable holy Orthodox patriarchs, and for the blessed ever memorable founders of this holy church, and for all our fathers and brethren, the Orthodox departed like before us, who here and all the world lie asleep in the Lord. Again we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation for the servants of God, Metropolitan Paul, Metropolitan John, held in captivity, all those suffering in the Middle East, seminarians and their families, the newly illumined Victor, Nancy with child, Timothy, those who are to be illumined, Mark, Virginia, Anastasia, Ivan, Gibbs, Evangeline, Leilani, Adele, Dawn, and for the pardon and remission of their sins. Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works, this holy and venerable house, and those who labor, and those who sing, and for all the people here present who await thy great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Without a merciful God, lovest mankind, thee we send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Praise to the Lord, ye catechumens. Let us, the faithful, pray for the catechumens, that the Lord may have mercy on them, that he may teach them the word of truth, that he may reveal to them the gospel of righteousness, that he may unite them to his holy Catholic and apostolic church. Save them, have mercy on them, help them, and keep them, O God, by thy grace. Bow your heads unto the Lord, ye catechumens. Thou with us, that may glorify thine honorable and majestic name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. All catechumens depart, depart catechumens, as many as are preparing for illumination, draw near. Pray ye who are preparing for illumination. Ye faithful, for the brethren who are preparing for holy illumination and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord. That the Lord our God may establish and strengthen them, that he may enlighten them with the light of knowledge and piety, that he may vouchsafe unto them in due time the labor of regeneration, the forgiveness of sins, and the robe of incorruptibility, that he may beget them by water and the Spirit, that he may bestow upon them the perfection of the faith, that he may number them with his holy and elect flock. Save them, have mercy on them, help them, and keep them, O God, by thy grace. As many as are preparing for illumination, bow your heads unto the Lord. For thou art illumination, unto thee do we send up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. As many as are preparing for illumination, depart. You who are preparing for illumination, depart. As many as are catechumens, depart. Let no catechumen remain. As many as are the faithful, again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom, O God, great and praiseworthy, who by the life-giving death of thy Christ has translated us from corruption to incorruption, do thou Free all our senses from deadly passions, set over them as a good guide the understanding that is within us, and let our eyes abstain from every evil sight, our hearing be inaccessible to idle words, and our tongues be purged of unseemly speech. Make clean our lips which praise thee, O Lord. Make our hands refrain from base deeds, and to work only that which is well pleasing to thee. Fortify our members and minds by thy grace. For unto thee art all glory, honor, worship to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Again and again in peace let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Wisdom, O Master, holy and exceeding good, we implore thee, who art rich in mercy, be gracious to us sinners, and make us worthy of the reception of thy only begotten Son and our God, the King of glory. For behold, his immaculate body and life-creating blood, entering at this present hour, about to be set forth upon this mystical table, by multitudes of heavenly hosts invisibly escorted, grant us to partake of them without condemnation, that through them our mental sight may be illumined, and we may become children of the light and of the day. Through the gift of thy Christ, with whom thou art blessed, together thine all holy, good, and life-creating Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Now the powers. Now all the powers of heaven invisibly with us do serve. Lo, the King of glory enters. Lo, the mystical sacrifice is a born fulfilled. Now the powers of heaven invisibly with us do serve. Lo, the King of glory enters. Lo, the mystical sacrifice is a born fulfilled. Now the powers of heaven invisibly with us do serve. Lo, the King of glory enters. Lo, the mystical sacrifice is a born fulfilled.
Thank you.
O Lord and Master of my life, give me not the spirit of sloth, despair, lust of power, and idle talk. But give rather the spirit of chastity, humility, patience, and love to thy servant. Yea, O Lord and King, grant me to see my own transgressions and not to judge my brother. For blessed art thou unto ages of ages. Amen. Let us complete our evening prayer unto the Lord. For the precious gifts offered and pre-sanctified, let us pray to the Lord. Let our God, who loves mankind, receiving them upon his holy, heavenly, and ideal altars, a sweet spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us and return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. That the whole evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord. An angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord. Pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord. A Christian ending to our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the judgment seat of Christ, let us ask. Having asked for the unity of the faith and the community of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and all our life unto Christ our God. O God of unutterable and unseen mysteries, with whom are the hidden treasures of wisdom and knowledge, who has revealed the service of this liturgy to us, who has sent us sinners through thy great love towards mankind to offer to thee gifts and sacrifices for our own sins and for the ignorance of the people, do thou thyself, O invisible King, who doest things great and inscrutable, glorious and marvelous, which cannot be numbered, look upon us, thine unworthy servants, who stand at this holy altar as at thy cherubic throne, upon which resteth thine only begotten Son, our God, and the dread mysteries that are set forth, and having freed us from all and all thy faithful people from uncleanness, sanctify all our souls and bodies with a sanctification which cannot be taken away, that partaking with a clean conscience, with faces unashamed, with hearts illumined of these divine sanctified things, and by them being given life, we may be united unto thy Christ himself, our true God, who has said, Whoso eateth my flesh and drinketh my blood, abideth in me, and I in him, and that by thy word, O Lord, dwelling within us, and sojourning among us, we may become the temple of thine all-holy and adorable Spirit, redeemed from every diabolical wall, wrought either by deed or word or thought, and may obtain the good things promised to us with all thy saints, who in all the ages have been well-pleasing unto thee. And make us worthy, O Master, that with boldness without condemnation, we may dare to call on thee the heavenly God as Father, and to say... Thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Peace be unto all. Bow your heads unto the Lord. O God, who alone art good and tender-hearted, who dwellest on high, who lookest upon the humble, look with the eye of thy tender-heartedness upon all thy people, and keep them, make us all worthy without condemnation to partake of these, thy life-creating mysteries from unto thee, have we bowed our heads awaiting from thee, thy rich mercies. through the grace and compassion, love toward mankind of thine only begotten Son, with whom thou art blessed, together with thine all holy, good, and life creating Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Let us attend. The priests sanctify holy things are for the holy. I believe, O Lord. I believe also truly that I know the therefore, I pray, have mercy on me and forgive my transgressions.
fear of God, with faith and love, draw near.
Oh.
O God, save thy people and bless thine inheritance. Always, now and ever, unto ages of ages.
Amen. Let our mouths be covered with thy praise, O Lord, and we may sing of thy glory. For thou hast made us worthy to partake of thy holy, divine, immortal, and life-creating mysteries. Keep us in thy holiness, that all the day we may meditate upon thy righteousness. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
Let us attend, have partaken of the holy, divine, immortal, life-creating, and divine mysteries of Christ. Let us worthily give thanks unto the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Asking that the whole evening may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us commend ourselves, one another, and all our life unto Christ our God. We give thanks unto thee, O God, the Savior of all men, for all the good things which thou hast vouchsafed unto us, and for the communion of the holy body and blood of thy Christ. And we beseech thee, O Lord, who lovest mankind, to keep us under the shelter of thy wings, and grant that even to our last breath we may worthily partake of thy holy things unto the enlightenment of soul and body, and unto the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven. For thou art our sanctification, unto thee we send the glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. Let us depart in peace. Let us pray to the Lord.
Almighty Master, whom wisdom has fashioned all creation, who through thine ineffable providence and great goodness has led us these all of your days for purification of souls and bodies, for restraint of passions, for hope of the resurrection, who during the 40 days didst put into the hands of thy servants and Moses the tables and letters divinely inscribed, grant unto us also a good one to fight the good fight, to complete the course of fast, preserve the faith undivided, to crush the heads of invisible serpents, to be shown to be conquerors of sin and without condemnation, also to attain unto and to worship the holy resurrection. For blessed and glorified is thine honorable and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore. Blessed be the name of the Lord, henceforth and forevermore.
The blessing will be upon you through his grace and love for mankind always, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to thee, O Christ, our God, and our hope, glory to thee. Christ, the true God, through the prayers of his most pure mother, the holy glorious, the love of apostles, evangelists, John the theologian, all the holy apostles, of our Father, among the saints, Gregory the Dialogus, the Pope of Rome, of Saint Eutychus, the patriarch of Constantinople, whose memory we celebrate today, and the holy and righteous ancestor of God, Joachim and Anna, of all the saints, have mercy on us and save us, for he is good and loveth mankind. Good evening to all this wonderful and glorious pre-sanctified liturgy. We have one more liturgy pre-sanctified this week on Friday, and also Friday will be our last potluck fellowship in the evening. And then many activities this week. So we have on Saturday, it is Lazarus Saturday, we'll be receiving the Minor family, also the Irwin family and Leilani into the church. So it's going to be a wonderful, splendid occasion. It'll begin at 9 o'clock in the morning, baptisms first, and then followed by liturgy. That evening we'll have a festal vigil for Palm Sunday, and in the afternoon we'll decorate the church for palms for Palm Sunday, and then we'll have Palm Sunday liturgy on Sunday, followed by a festal meal afterwards. So make
God bless you and keep you and continue to preserve you as we reach the end of our mission journey.
as the kingdom of the power and the glory of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and into ages of ages.
The prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy on us.
Oh.